welcome back for another Species Spotlight. I'm Miss Nicole here at the garden. This week's Species Spotlight is the Gumbo Limbo tree. A lot of you might have heard this tree being referred to as the tourist tree, and that's because this red peely bark kind of resembles sunburn, like some of our tourists might get when they come into our strong Florida Keys sunshine. What's super unique about this bark is that underneath of it, when you scratch away some of this peely stuff, is green. So most tree bark is not green, but the Gumbo Limbo tree has green bark because the green is actually from chlorophyll, which is a part of photosynthesis where a plant turns sunlight into food. Normally, the chlorophyll is found in the leaves of trees, which makes this super unique. What does that really mean though? If a hurricane comes along and blows away all of the leaves, a tree can no longer produce the chlorophyll for the food it needs for photosynthesis. But this unique tree can do that without having the leaves. So the sunlight gets absorbed into this bark and the chlorophyll does its hard work to turn the sunshine into food. Something else that makes these trees so unique and important down here in the Florida Keys is that they're very salt resistant and wind resistant. So when a bunch of salty wind comes in, blows off all of their leaves, they can still make their food and they are durable and strong. They will last throughout that storm. So it makes these trees extremely important. Gumbo Limbos actually have small little berries, which are a little hard to see since they're so high up there. The berries get eaten by mockingbirds and barrow birds, which then eat the seeds and spread them along, and that's how our tree can continue to populate and grow. They also have small clusters of little white and green flowers that bees pollinate. And something else, a little fun fact, is that the dingy purple butterfly lays its eggs on the Gumbo Limbo leaves. So then that's how we help populate our dingy purple butterflies. Thanks for joining me for this week's Species Spotlight about our wonderful tourist trees.